Lawyers have wrapped up the first part of the Sex for Contracts trial involving former Singapore Civil Defence Force Chief Peter Lim. Pang Chor Mui, a woman he's linked to, takes the stand next month.
The prosecution suggested that former SCDF Chief Peter Lim was beholden to Ms. Pang Chor Mui after the oral sex between them took place. And the opportunity to return the favour only came when the SCDF required equipment to deal with the threat of radiation fallout. They pointed to the fact that in the months following the oral sex, the SCDF hadn't called any tenders for security equipment, devices which Ms. Pang's company, Nimrod Engineering, would have been able to supply. Wrapping up the first leg of the trial, the prosecution alleged that Lim tipped off Ms. Pang about SCDF's need for radiation detection equipment after they engaged in oral sex. Nimrod does not supply such equipment. It was established over the 4 days that the oral sex took place on May 2, 2010, months before Lim first sounded the alert to his officers in March 2011 that the agency needed more walk-through radiation portal monitors. Around that time, Ms. Pang asked her colleague to source for suppliers of these very same monitors, way before the SCDF's tender for these devices went public. The tender was later cancelled and a fresh one launched with tighter specifications. Witnesses have been called to corroborate the timeline of events before Ms. Pang, the star witness, takes the stand. It's also been established that Nimrod Engineering was already a vendor for the SCDF at the time the oral sex took place, supplying the agency with metal detectors as well as aftercare warranty for the equipment. That in itself, charged the prosecution, constitutes a conflict of interest. On the stand today was Roger Wong, assistant director for the SCDF's purchasing branch. He gave his opinion that Lim, as chairman of a tender board that gave final approval, shouldn't have inquired about a product with a company representative he had oral sex with, as that counted as conflict of interest. The prosecution has alleged that he did so. Mr. Wong also said the different roles in the procurement process were clearly defined and that the chairman of a tender board should not make inquiries with suppliers or do market research. The trial resumes next month.